What up, everybody? It's iPadBeatMaking.com here on Friday, October 30th, 2020, giving you some news you can use. Now, before we begin, please hit the like button if you enjoy this video, as well as the subscribe button if you aren't currently subscribed, so that you don't miss any of the latest news, tutorials, beats, reviews, tips, tricks, and more. Now, Halloween is tomorrow, but what scares some Americans more than spending the night alone in a haunted house is that we're on the eve of yet another election. In fact, by the time I see you next week, a president for the next presidential term will be elected. Now, this is an election that some say matters more than ever, and there's predictions that riots and beyond might happen as a result. Now, whether that is actually the case or not, we'd like to encourage everybody to stay safe and stay respectful. No matter what your views or anyone else's are, everyone has a perspective, and we're glad that iPhone and iPad beat making and music creation in general has brought so many of us together that might not otherwise interact at all, and that's a beautiful thing. 2020 has been different for us all, but one thing we've learned is that life is too short to not be happy and make the most of it. It's been a breath of fresh air to have this great iOS music making community, as well as all these incredible music apps that we can carry in our pocket. Anyways, with that said, happy Halloween if you celebrate it. Now let's get to the news. First off, Apple has released the new iPad Air, which greatly resembles the iPad Pro. We're very excited about it, and it is said to be faster than the iPad Pro, but we're seeing that lots of people aren't actually opting to grab it, feeling that an older iPad Pro is a better buy due to the fact that storage options are higher, and it has 4 speakers instead of 2, the screen is bigger, and has 120Hz ProMotion refresh rates for smoother scrolling and a better overall viewing experience. What are your thoughts? For those who have grabbed iPads recently, which one did you grab and why? Let us know in the comments section. Now, Iceworks has released a new app called Kashiba Sequence Gate Effects, which looks really cool. Quote, Kashiba is a 16-step gate sequencer plugin effect that can transform a sustained sound into a rhythmic phrase. Each step of the gate is synchronized to the beat of the DAW and has different volume, pan, filter, LFO, and envelope parameters. The steps can be tied together to create longer gates, and Kashiba includes a filter delay that allows you to set a different amount of effect sends for each step. And it's also a universal app. It is compatible with iPad and iPhone and has multiple screen layouts optimized for different screen sizes. Looks very cool. Be sure to check that out if that interests you. Oh, it can't be good music, my Grammy family. Now, a collective we'll refer to as the Grammy family, which features Henny the Business. Yes, this the business. The business. We like her, and we like her too. And we like her, we like her too. We like her, and we like her too. Sorry, that gave us flashbacks. Wow. Good times with that song. But yes, they have just released their first app, Housemark One, and it's a collaborative effort backed by AudioKit Pro's open source code. Now, this app's been a year in the making, and they even involve students at Morehouse in the making of it. Now, the story behind this is incredible, and they do a great job introducing you to their app, so we'll just play their video.
As music creators, we are inspired by the world that surrounds us. That inspiration doesn't always happen in the studio, but when it does happen, we want to be able to create. We want to have access to the tools, our instruments that we use at any given time.
Being on this iOS music production journey for the last 5 years has truly showed me just how powerful these apps and this platform is. Through the years, I've seen amazing apps from awesome developers, and it's got me thinking about what's next, what's in store. Now, after a year in development and educating our students on how to code using AudioKit Pro's platform, we present you the House Mark One app.
The vintage sound of the electric piano is a staple in our production. Kenny and I are both keyboard players. The keyboard, piano, are instrumental in all the records that we produce. We want to have access to that at any given time. And we want it to sound just like it sounded in the studio. Kenny and I partner with AudioKit, using their open source code to bring this app to life.
Now, why did we do this? For me, it goes back to having a specific app for a specific task. And the first app we definitely wanted to bring to our community was something that we could play every single day on the records that we create. But not only that, it was a perfect way for us to educate our students in sampling, in coding, and app development over at Morehouse College.
When we started developing this, we looked at it as an educational experience. How do we teach our students about sampling, mic placement, sample rates, converters? This provided the perfect opportunity to see the end product in an iOS app that each one of those students could have in their pocket.
We wanted to show our students exactly the capabilities of building an app and what that means for their future as they look into getting into music production, app development, and the like.
We wanted to keep this app simple. We wanted it to do what it needed to do, and that is sound great. So we sampled every bit of it, not only the tones coming out of the instrument, but also the key noise when you press it, the foot pedal noise when you sustain. We wanted it all in there to give you the feel of sitting down and playing this vintage instrument.
But also making sure the file size wasn't too big, as we knew we wanted to make this an AUV3 plugin so that you can use it multiple times on multiple DAWs, however you would like it.
So that's what we wanted to give you. We wanted to give you a quality, real emulation of an instrument that we go to on countless records.
And even through beta testing, we made sure not only did we send that out to people who are very hip to iOS, but also those who are touring and studio musicians who have probably never used the platform before.
It's not only a studio tool, but an incredible touring tool. No one wants to lug around a 150-pound electric piano.
I'm gonna be honest, bringing an app to the community was definitely something that I wanted to make sure I got right and made sure that it made sense for me. Because all in all, if I don't use it and I don't believe in it, why should you? So this is the House Mark One, and we really love the hell out of this thing, man. Hopefully you will as well.
Brought to you by us, Westview Drive and Audio Kid.
So, what's your thoughts on this app? Will you be grabbing it? We did, and we like it a lot. Now, to celebrate this app's release, as well as to celebrate one of the Audio Kit team members having a baby, the Audio Kit apps have gone on sale for $3.99 for a limited time only. Now, these apps at one point had been $1,000, then they went to $100, and now they're only $3.99. This includes Bass 808 Synth, Retro Piano, as well as Audio Tune. So be sure to check those out. The House Mark One app will be on sale for $3.99 for a limited time. It will eventually shoot up to $15 or $14.99. So be sure to grab that as soon as possible if it interests you, so you can get it at the great price. Now let's get to the updates. Now Audio Modeling, which recently collaborated with GeoShred to make GeoSwarm and currently has iOS Swarm instrument apps in the works, has updated its Camelot app to version 2. Camelot has been drastically improved since 1.x. Now we're gonna do just a brief summary of these things. We're not gonna actually read line by line everything. We're gonna skip through this a little bit, but we're just gonna give you a general idea. First, we got timeline and automations, audio backing tracks with dedicated audio output selection, and basic editing. Audio effects plugins insert on each layer, MIDI processor plugins on each layer, layer connectors, special item routing MIDI to any layer to manage, new edit mode with drag and drop items reordering, templates, selectable layer audio output, new edit mode with drag and drop layer reordering, song and set list rack override, possibility to manage multiple devices of same model with smart maps. Okay, we don't even need to go any further. This app update is huge. If this in any way pertains to your workflow or your needs, you should definitely get on top of grabbing this app, because it definitely seems like it's alive and well and it's being constantly improved. So be sure to check out Camelot 2 by Audio Modeling. And the beauty of it is they also have a desktop version. So say you're not iOS only, you can use this app on desktop also. I don't know how the files go back and forth, but it's definitely something to look into if it interests you. Now, Apple has elected to update GarageBand, and this version is 2.3.9. Quote, new audio recordings can be quickly started from the home screen by touching and holding the GarageBand app icon. Maximum song length at default tempo has been increased from 23 to 72 minutes. The ruler now offers an option to switch from musical bars and beats to minutes and seconds. New downloadable keyboard collection sound pack includes over 150 keyboard loops and 50 instrument patches like pianos, organs, and electric pianos. So Apple is giving you the most value of any audio DAW with GarageBand. It's always getting new sounds and updates and features added. Might not be the features you want, but somebody wants them, and these things matter to somebody. So this update is really cool. Now, my GarageBand users out there, why do you like GarageBand? What are your favorite features about it? Would you ever consider jumping to another DAW, or are you strictly GarageBand and that's what you're rolling with? I think GarageBand is a really powerful app that a lot of people really don't give a second look, but I'd like to hear from you and other people I'm sure would like to learn. What do you like about GarageBand? So please let us know in the comment section and let's have a conversation about it. Now, NeoSoul Keys 2 has been updated so that you can now purchase an in-app purchase of a new keyboard model that they have. I have not heard this model yet, but it looks really cool. I'll be sure to check it out at some point. So if that interests you or you've been waiting on that, be sure to check that out. Now, Blocks Wave has been updated to support iOS 14. Analyzer and Tuner AUV3 plugin has improved the functionality and reliability of the tuner display. New Rack AUV3 effects processor has added a new audio tuner module with note, sense, and frequency display. Added 4 more strumming patterns to the MIDI strummer module. Added a note length option to MIDI strummer and made other small improvements. Fixed an issue which caused the sound font player to crash when loading a sound font during MIDI playback. Voloco has been updated with more effects, including 2 new packs, LOL and Spooky, and they also brought back Medium Room Reverb. Groovebox Beat and Synth Studio has been updated to support iOS 14. Volt Synth has fixed an issue where attempting to connect many Bluetooth devices would cause the app to crash in some cases. They also fixed an issue where effect controls would not work properly. They also fixed an issue where the preset browser was missing when running on an iPhone 11 Pro Max or iPhone XS Max. Now, Red Rock Audio has updated their suite of plugins to fix plugin state save and restore bug on iOS 14. Decent Samples has added support for multiple presets within a single sample library. A ton of bugs fixed. More sample libraries coming soon. Shimmer AUV3 audio plugin has fixed an iOS 14 issue which prevented the touchpads from functioning correctly. Koala Sampler has also been updated and it now has much better waveform rendering, much optimized graphics for older devices, fixed audio cutting out when returning from importing audio on some newer iPads. Launchpad has been updated to support iOS 14. Sound Fonts has added improved detection when another app controls audio, keeping Sound Fonts from being able to generate audio output, fixed UI issues involving Sound Fonts with one preset, and more. Now, our app of the week is a bit different this week. It's all of AudioKit's limited edition apps, as well as their newly released Housemark One app. These apps are not available for cheap very often, so we want to take the time to highlight them and why we love them enough to name them the apps of the week. Now, their 808 app unlocked 808 accessibility across every single DAW, which is really cool. It gave access to a lot of cool parameters like glide, modulation, length, distort, not to mention it comes with some really cool stock sounds inside of there created by incredible producers, including a few presets made by us at iPad Beatmaking. So we definitely love that app. Now, the Retro Piano gave a unique take on the piano with something you really only hear on a desktop with apps like maybe Omnisphere, or I don't even know if Omnisphere has anything like this. It might because it's got so many sounds, but this app is really special. I actually find myself going to it and really liking its unique piano sounds. It's real grimy, real grungy, real different than things that you would normally find on iOS, especially where everyone's trying to model the most realistic, cleanest, you know, museum level piano. But this is the complete opposite. It's dirty, it's wrecked, it's just got so much character, you know. So I really love that Retro Piano app. I advise everybody to take a look at that also. And their Audio Tune app finally unlocked access to auto tune capabilities in an app that was built from the ground up for iOS. This has been very, very high on my list for probably years now, because for my particular genre of music that I work with artists in, there's a lot of auto tune involved. People will be open to the idea of maybe recording on an iPhone or an iPad, but then you say there's no auto tune and they're like, well, hold on a second, I'm basing my whole style around that effect. So the fact that we've got audio tune now is incredible. So be sure to check that out. Even if you have no use for any of these apps today, they're limited edition. Grab these apps while you have a chance to. And the beautiful Grammy family creation that is Housemark One. I mean, do I really need to say anything else? You saw the video. Everyone's going crazy about this app. Be sure to check it out. You can't beat it. $3.99. I mean, come on. For all these apps, just collect them. Be Thanos. Each of these apps are one of the Infinity Stones. Grab them all and take over the universe. It's just that simple. Anyways, those are our apps of the week. And with that said, we're going to get to the winner of the GeoShred giveaway. We ran all of the comments through a randomizer, so there are no favorites and no gimmicks. We screen recorded it, and we'll play that now. So, congratulations. We will be hitting you up shortly. To everyone who participated, we appreciate it. Now let's move on to sales. Now, there are a ton of sales this week, so get to the App Store and get ready to drain your bank account. Don't say I didn't warn you. Now, we've got Sample List, which is on sale for $2.99 until November 1st. We've got Pure Acid down to $7.99 from $14.99. You definitely need to grab Korg Module Pro, which is still 50% off. It will end soon at the beginning of November, I believe, so be sure to grab that. Volt Synth, which is usually $19.99, is currently $9.99. KB1 Keyboard Suite is usually $9.99, it's currently $4.99. Shockwave Synth Module is currently on sale for $9.99 from the price of $19.99. Audio Share, which is usually $4, is currently on sale for $1.99. AUM Audio Mixer, which is usually $19.99, is currently on sale for $14.99. Magellan, which is usually $14.99, is on sale for $6.99. Cauldron, which is usually $9.99, is on sale for $4.99. Sample Toy, which is usually 99 cents, is currently free. Key Tuner is usually $1.99. It's also currently free. Audio Kit L7 AUV3 Live Looper is usually $9.99. It's currently on sale for $2.99. Audio Kit Digital D1 is usually $5.99. It's currently on sale for $4.99. Drum Tune Pro Drum Tuner is usually $8.99. It's currently on sale for $7.99. And X Drummer, which is usually $19.99, is currently on sale for $9.99. RE1 Tape Machine, which is usually $9.99, is down to $4.99. Magellan Synthesizer 2, which is usually $14.99, is currently $6.99. Casper, which is usually $19.99, is down to $9.99. Sector, which is usually $7.99, is currently $3.99. And the AUFX suite of plugins is currently down to $2.99 from the usual price of $4.99. OBXD AEV3 Synth is usually $7. It's currently $3.99. FD1 Filter Delay is usually $9.99. It's currently $4.99. PSA 1000 Junior is usually $14.99. It's currently $7.99. RM1 Wave Modulator is down from $7.99 to $3.99. Cali Reverb Modern High Gain is usually $19.99. It's currently $9.99. Delay 3000 Vintage Modern is currently $4.99, down from its usual price of $9.99. Soundmaster Custom Tube is usually $19.99. It's currently $9.99. MRH 810 Lead Series is usually $19.99 also, and it's also currently at $9.99. PSA 1000, another app that's usually $19.99, it's currently $9.99 as well. RP1 Delay is currently $2.99, down from $5.99. RF1 Reverb is also down from $5.99 and currently at $2.99. And the Analog Rack Suite of Plugins from Nembrini is currently $1.99 as opposed to the usual price of $4.99 each. The Boss Dial Distortion is usually $4.99. It's currently $2.99. OPL AEV3 FM Synth is usually $6.99. It's currently $3.99. SF1 Stereo Filter is usually $5.99. It's currently $2.99. Idolizer is usually $9.99. It's currently $4.99. And VC1 Course is usually $5.99. And it's currently $2.99. Koshiba, which we mentioned earlier, is on sale until November 3rd. Groove Rider GR16 is currently $9.99, down from $18.99. Poison 202 Vintage Synthesizer is currently $4.99, down from $9.99. Taxime World Synth and Drum Pad Machine is currently free from the original price of $5.99. Fugue Machine MIDI Sequencer is currently $5 when it's usually $10. Navicord is still on sale at $5 when it's usually $9. Audio Kit Hey Metronome is currently $1 when it's usually $2. Kraft or KRFT is currently $4 when it's usually $15. And the suite of audio kit apps that we mentioned before are currently $4, down from $1,000, $100, and the Housemark One will soon be $15. So be sure to check out those apps. And with that said, we're gonna get up out of here. We hope you enjoyed our news today on October 30th, 2020. If you did, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you're not currently subscribed, please be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of the latest sales, news, tips, tricks, beats, tutorials, and more. And as always, be sure to check out some of the best kits available for iOS at iPadBeatMaking.com. It's iPadBeatMaking.com. Peace.